Remove the E-ring from the small gear side of the drum axle shaft. Remove the drum axle from the large gear side of the drum. If you try to pull it out from the small gear side, the shaft will jam up on the ground contact inside the drum and damage the contact. Remove the old drum. Remove the charge roller. The holders will come out with a charge roller. Do not touch the roller with your finger. You may cause printing problems, like extra marks on the page. Remove the two screws from the wiper blade. Remove the wiper blade. Clean out all the remaining toner from the cartridge. If possible, use compressed air. It would be better to use a toner workstation. If not, clean the cartridge as well as possible at open air. Do not breathe the toner dust. Be careful not to damage the recovery blade that is located next to the wiper blade. If this blade is bent in any way, the cartridge will leak. The wiper blade is probably reusable. Clean the wiper blade with isopropyl alcohol. Coat the edge of the wiper blade with toner or other lubricant, like Kinner. Clean the charge roller using a soft cloth. The charge roller places the initial charge on the drum, as well as erases the residual charge at the end of the cycle. Install the wiper blade and the two screws. Reinstall the charge roller holders. Install the charge roller. Lubricate the drum with toner, or the wiper blade may damage it. Install the drum so that the large gear is on the left side, spring on the small gear facing down. Install a drum axle. Install the E-ring. To make sure that everything is meshing properly, rotate the drum by the gear in the proper direction. And the work is done. You'll find reset instructions in the description of this video. In case of back grounding, clean the charge roller with isopropyl alcohol. Then, if you stored the drum unit for a long time, insert a sheet between the drum and the charge roller, or the charge roller will stick on the drum. For any problem with the cartridge, here you'll find a troubleshooting guide.